lipoma on the legs. You can see this big lipoma is there in the thigh. There is another big lipoma here. He has multiple small lipomas. This lump is so big that this, so because of this, he's always wearing loose dresses so he can hide these swellings. He is always scared whenever he get married, or when his family or his near and dears, when they see about this, how they will react, what they will think about it. And that is the commonest concern, with not only with him, with the many patients, especially premarital, when these lipomas occur at around the age of 23-24, and after that when the person gets married. And because he knows that this is not a problem, this is not a disease, but the other one, the second person, whosoever is, who do not have this problem, he will think this is a disease, and they will think that this, why he has not told me about this and all that. But this is a very simple problem. This can happen to anyone, and this is not tumor, not cancer. Definitely small lumps is are always benign, but sometimes these big lumps can turn into the malignancy. Though in the case of multiple lipoma, this tendency is very, very less. The chances are bleak that this can get converted into cancer. But when we are doing the minimal invasive technique, we are not making any big cut. We will make a very small hole through which this complete lipoma will be removed. Similarly, hair also will grow through a very small micro incision through which we can take out the complete lipoma. And these incisions are so small that we need not take any stitches for them. So no stitch marks, very small hole, and we just cover it with the normal band-aid. Do not require dressings. Within 3 to 5 days this heals, and patient is up and above very next day. Within 7 to 10 days he can resume his duties, he can resume his duty from the next day only, but within short time he can start doing his normal physical activity like gym and running within 7 to 10 days. Now another modality which is coming up for this, that some patient think, why not do a liposuction for this? Though this is fat cells, it is not normal fat. For normal fat, like if this is the fat, I want to remove it, definitely I have long big instrument, I will melt this fat and take it away. But when this big lipoma is there, if I try to hammer it and make it very small pieces, there is always chance that this will spread many ways. I have got many patients where they had done the liposuction, and he had one or two such lipomas, and then they come to us, they have 20 to 30 lipomas because they break it in small pieces and leave it at different places. So lipoma of thigh, as such, normally it's not causing any big problems, but they are not causing difficulty in walking. But some patients, when the lipoma is on the medial side, we start rubbing also and they cause problem. In this patient they are big. This do not cause big problem. I have seen some lipomas, some patients have come with the lipoma in the pubic region, where the lipoma is so big that their penis becomes buried in that, and in that case they are facing the problem in their private life, they are facing some problem, and in that case we remove the lipoma and patient become very comfortable. So wherever in the body we can remove all these lipomas without making any bigger cuts. Unless there is a doubtful lipoma, where there is a chance of malignancy, we must take a big incision and try to remove it. But most cases, wherever the multiple lipomas are there, the chances of malignancy is negligible. So we need not make big cuts for these lipomas. There was a big, huge lipoma in this region, which we have already removed. When we are removing such big lipomas, this is the lipoma of the leg. He has multiple big lipomas on the leg. This one big, which was in the medial side of the thigh, which we have removed, and it was quite big lipoma, almost 15 by 6 cm size, or even bigger than that, we have removed. But when we have removed, there is always chance of skin becoming loose. So many patients ask, when this loose skin, what you will do with this loose skin? Whenever there is a loose skin after the removal of big lipomas, there is also always a possibility of seroma formation, that fluid may accumulate in this. Another problem is this skin may remain lax and keep on just like a lax skin will remain in the body, and it will just patient will feel some fold is hanging. But this doesn't happen whenever we are using this technique, because though this is loose at present, but within few days this will become absolutely a part. But whatever the stretching which has happened already, the skin has a good tendency to recover, and there will not be any loose skin or hanging skin later on. But the only thing which can happen is if we do not give nice pressure in this area, or if the patient do not take the precaution, he can get some fluid will develop in this region, which may require aspiration. Which is, though it is very rare, but this can happen. But that's not a problem. That's a very simple process. It can be done in OPD. No need for to do any admission or anything. Or it can just come out anytime. Most of the times we do not need to do anything. This fluid, body absorbs it by itself. This will accumulate for some time, and then body will resolve it by itself. Now you can see there is no, you can see any cut marks or anything. We have completely removed. You cannot identify from where we have removed. If we go very close, I can show you this small hole. I have not taken any stitches, nothing. I will just put a dressing. After 3 to 5 days, when the patient remove, this will be completely healed. So when I take out the dressing, this will be completely healed. You can see this big lipoma we have removed through this small hole, and you can see the skin has become lax. Definitely it is little lax for some time. Gradually it will become perfectly normal, just like this skin.